Hello, friends. This is Eli with Mystic Circuits. Today we are on part two of our Zero HP video series, showing how to use the Zero HP modules with various semi-modular synths that are available. Today we are taking a look at the Moog Mother 32. And we will go over some patch examples of doing interesting things with the Zero HP synths in conjunction with the Mother 32. So in this patch, we are using a Zero HP VCA AND gate. It is being fed by the auxiliary output, rather the assign output, which is giving us a random voltage, sample and hold, stepped random kind of signal. You can see the LED turn on and off with the assign output controlling it. And whenever the LED is high, our LFO is being sent into the 1 volt per octave input of the VCO. So if I turn the LFO up, you can hear some frequency modulation start to enter the equation whenever the light is high. The nice thing about this is that you can have varying amounts of frequency modulation depending on the value of the sample and hold. We are also using a Zero HP envelope. It's a little superfluous in this situation because there is an internal envelope, but the nice thing about the Zero HP envelope as opposed to the built-in envelope is that it can be voltage controlled. So if we take the FM out, turn cutoff all the way down, VCA mode is on. You can hear that the internal envelope has no effect. We can still see. Oh, wait. Now we can still see the value of the assign output, and you can see when the assign output is high, the notes are shorter. Let's contrast that to the internal envelope. You can hear it has more of an effect because there's less signal loss, but it's also more static. So if we use them both in conjunction, especially if we just want that little pluck at the beginning to keep the notes bright, but then the Zero HP envelope almost gives it more of a sustain release sort of shape with voltage control over the release. I'm going to go ahead and plug the LFO in. Instead of the assign output, so that we get a sort of more regular control over the envelope shape. It's a more stark contrast when we use the square wave So using both envelopes in conjunction can give you some nice shapes with a little bit of voltage control over it. Okay, in this example, we are using a 0HP AND gate to give us some nice amplitude modulation before going into the filter. So this is crossfading between the amplitude modulated signal and the normal signal. Here we're amplitude modulating the pulse width, rather the pulse output of the VCO with the LFO output triangle. And all of that is being routed into our external audio input. Get some interesting ring modulation sorts of sounds. If we want to spice it up a little bit, we can take our 0HP attenuator, take the assign output, which is still a sample and hold, and run it into the LFO array. That way we have light control over the pitch of the LFO. As well as some randomness to the amplitude modulation sound. You can also use the keyboard if you want the notes to move in conjunction. This patch shows off a little bit about how to get some interesting variation in the pattern by using a 0HP AND gate VCA. It's being controlled by the assign output. Again, it's a sample and hold based random. The square wave LFO is going to the VCA's input, and the output is going to the reset input. So the combination of the speed of the LFO and the random value that we are getting out of a sign determines when the sequence jumps back to one. If I speed up the sequence a bit, it'll be more apparent. See when the LED lights up, the sequence resets. In reality, both this LED from the assigned input and the LFO have to be high at the same time for a reset to happen. You can also run this into the hold input, and the sequence will just stay on a particular step for an extra couple of cycles. So in this patch, we have our 0HP envelope again, still being driven by the main gate output. The release time is being controlled by our triangle LFO, and the output is going into the mix CV. So when the envelope is high, it's mixing in the noise that you hear. If I unplug the envelope, you can hear it's just the normal tone. Plug back in the envelope, it adds a little bit of grit. In this particular patch, I have the assign output going to our mult, which I'm now using to open this 0HP AND gate VCA. It's controlling the amount of noise that's being sent into the cutoff frequency modulation for the filter. And then just to add a little bit more slop, I'm gonna take a second envelope, use it to slew the keyboard voltage going into the 1 volt per octave input of our oscillator. I'm gonna use the random sample and hold voltage to control the amount of slew with that as well. You get a nice kind of dirty, things are not quite on the grid anymore kind of sound to it. We can also use the square wave LFO. Get something real nasty. You can hear how it's still being slewed. Here, the gate is what's driving the slew. So you're getting transposition that's on the grid. Let's try driving that with the triangle LFO. This is a rather nice patch using the 0HP OR gate. In this case, we're not using it on gates, but on voltages. We can run two modulation sources in and it will combine them. So in this case, we're using the envelope generator and the triangle LFO, using both in conjunction to control the VCF cutoff. Whichever voltage is higher is the one that will be present at the OR gate output. So we're essentially performing a voltage maximum between the envelope and the LFO. Basically what this means is that whenever the envelope is high, you're gonna get an envelope. Whenever the LFO is high, you're gonna get an LFO. So it lets you combine both kinds of modulation in a nice way. So you can hear when the envelope is open, the LFO's effect goes away, and then when it closes off, the LFO's effect comes back. Get slucky percussive aspect of the envelope, keeping everything sounding like it's on the grid, while the LFO kind of does its own thing and adds some variation to the rhythm. Here we're using the same principle for some pulse width modulation. Here we are using the same principle for some pulse width modulation. Just using the envelope, in this case on the filter. This patch is completely LFO driven. The sequencer is unused at the moment. What we have is our 0HP attenuator plugging the triangle output of the LFO back into the LFO rate modulation input. So if we apply a different amount of light to the attenuator, the LFO shape and speed will both change, since the LFO is modulating itself. Obviously, this has different effects at different speeds. You get kind of like a heartbeat sort of sound right there. Now, the square wave LFO is opening up the 0HP Vactrol VCA, which is sending noise into the 1 volt per octave input. So now we have a clean oscillator sound, and now we have noise modulating the oscillator for half of the LFO cycle. Nice in conjunction with the sequencer as well. Gives sort of more motion to a sequence. Just have an LFO picking out notes. And that's it for the Mother 32. Great synth for 0HPs, lots of modulation possibilities, internal sequencer, and attenuators on just about all of the modulation inputs. It works quite nicely with the 0HP modules. Thank you for watching.